to the street so people can see it and be attracted to it. And then Max needs to create a shopping area visible and appealing to the community, as well as like a sort of a meeting hangout location people can go in. And my third point to create was to integrate the market into the community by creating a community center to serve the needs of the local population, which will benefit both the market and the neighborhood.
Those are your ideas, you completely...
Correct, those are mine, yeah. So like I started design by creating the objectives so that way I wouldn't fall off track or just go in a different direction. So I have that in mind. So then I started my research, that's probably create some charts about the basics of the most important neighborhood and also the mode of transportation, how many people walk, how many people take the subway, drove in that area. It's kind of important to see what's...
What is that? It's the light blue.
The light blue is actually the amount of people that take the subway.
Mm-hmm.
So the 42% of the population in that area take the subway. 1.2% driver costs, 14% of that take the bus. We have 90% that just walk, which is kind of a big number. As a president, I looked over at least the Oxford public market in Napa Valley. The reason I picked this one as a president is because I saw that the bricks with the glass and the interaction, and I felt like, wow, that's what this market needs, like some sort of interaction between transparency and the hard surfaces, the brick. And then the other one that I took was the Prince Market in Boston, because I actually was there and I saw that they bring the market inside, outside, especially in the winter, by having these vendors just on the outside of the market. So that's sort of a good approach to people that are passing by just to see that. Because otherwise, it's a very solid building, you can't see inside. Okay. So the first thing I need to do it was to create a device that will bring the inside to outside. So I start off by creating a vegetable cart, like a vegetable for the market. So that was my initial design. Just the cart, and what it does, it brings the stuff outside, but it folds itself. So during the winter of the cold season, it can be brought back inside. Now the second part of it was, so if I'm gonna open the market in the streets, I need to find a way of closing the market. So what I did is I create a canopy that will go in the facade and punch through the facade holes where those cars will be between. So during the summer will be the canopy, and then in the winter time, those canopies can work as a door. So just close it in. So let's see how I integrate all these elements to the market. Well, first start with the roof plan. And on the roof plan, I wanted to maximize the space in that market, so I did a garden roof, so people can go in. I took the skylights that they have, and I created one skylight that connects to two entrances. I changed the entrance a little bit for them on each corner, because I think that's where people will be passing the most and be more attracted to go. And then on the inside, the skylight follows the path to the vendors and everything else. So on the first floor plan, we can see where the northwest entrance and the southwest entrance, where you're going to pass by the flow of the market. So those of you who are the push carts that comes outside, and they can also use it inside. So this kind of creates a bigger space for the vendors as well, because now they're going to be displaying inside and out. And in the middle of you here is some more vendor booths. And if you keep walking in this direction, you're going to hit the food court where there is a central staircase that will take you to the roof garden and also to the basement. And the restroom, the bathroom, the service area is a little bit over there. And on this side of the gear, which is the Moore Street side, there's a flower shop on this side, which can also be open so people who are passing on the Puerto Rican Avenue, the Granite Avenue, they can see the flowers over here, so that might attract some people to come towards. This is the basement. So basically in the basement, so the top part would be only for food, vegetables, that sort of thing. And in the basement would be more stores. We would put all the stores in the community center that would attract people. So basically, to go to the community center, you have to walk through the whole market. So you have to see everything that's going on in order to get there. And so this sort of will bring more people in. And this is a reflecting sewer plant, which the skylights represent the main path, and then those lights running across will be on top of the vendors. So instead of having the booths closed, they're being closed with lights, which I'll show you in a little bit. So the elevation of the building elevation is the west elevation, which is on Bull Street, the main entrance. So everything is open, the food carts come out, we have trees. The terrace, there's this gesture openings. So if you're down below, you can see there's something going on up there, people walking. And we have this out in the north elevation. The perspective of the whole market, you can see the entrances. I enlarged the main entrances on the corners. The track market as well. And we have a cross section, which you can see what sort of the basement where the stores will be, the community center, and the top part, skylight running across, the hanging lights. Those hanging lights, they came from inspiration of the market. Some of the vendors, they have like pots and pans that they sell in there, and it's hanging like all around the market. So that kind of stuff, you know, those hanging lights came from that. So long section, the basement. So this big space in the bottom is the community center. Just a color rendering. Okay. So this is how the doors basically work. During the summertime they're open, and then in the wintertime they close. But you still, you know, you can't see through because the gestures that were made here were also translated into the doors. So people pass by, you can see that. Oh, this is just a view of the buildings around the site, because they do influence a little bit, especially regarding this canopy. Because when we did like a shadow light study, so those buildings were used to determine how long would the canopy need to be in order to really work out with the fruit and vegetable stands during the summer. Just the next couple of things would be just some images of outside and inside. Well, this is inside in the food court. And there's that central staircase, which above, there's some skylights as well. Next to that, just bring the light to that main area, sitting area. A couple more images. And this is from the west side entrance, just as you walk in. And you can see the central booth, so the vendors still can hang their pans and pots on top of this food vendors there. And there's an animation too. It's kind of a walkthrough animation. It's going to give you more insight of what's going on inside of this building. It'll get a 2-minute animation.